Welcome to the Make and Design Podcast. I'm your host, Carina Gardner. On this podcast, we're unraveling the everyday joys and dilemmas of design, making, and business. For makers who want to be designers and for designers who are makers, this is your inside scoop to help you grow your business and bring more creativity to your life. Hey guys, today I want to talk about drawing. Okay, I hear this so often. I can't become a designer because I can't draw. You guys, designers typically never drew, not like from the very beginning of time. Illustrators drew, fine artists drew. Designers, we create organization. We're solution builders. So we would take the illustrator's drawings, we would take the fine artist stuff, and then we would make it all work to make sense for commercial art. That's why we used to be called commercial artists, right? You have to know how to set up your type so that the hierarchy made sense. You were making sure that the eye moved a certain way so you can see certain dynamics. So you guys, just because you can't draw doesn't mean you can't be a designer. And let's just take it to the next level. Maybe you say you need to draw because you want to be a fabric designer, or you want to be drawing your own SVG files or whatever. Maybe your own fonts. Here is the bottom line. The computer has made it so easy for us to learn how to draw. If you are in one, or you've taken one of my design boot camps, you know we do a couple of Illustrator lessons just to illustrate some things that you can do. On day one, we make a ladybug together, and in that ladybug, we use shapes, you guys. We use shapes to build our illustration. So you don't have to be a great drawer. You just have to know how to get everything organized. And that's the way I did it for years. I now do draw quite a bit, but it's only because I've gotten used to the idea. For the longest time, I was like, I don't draw. I'm not an illustrator. I'm a designer. That's a totally different thing. And now we kind of see those things merged, especially in the industries I'm in, where it's like fabric and paper. We're doing a lot more drawing to get where we need to go. Okay. But I hate that excuse. You guys, if you feel like you can't draw, get yourself on the computer and start drawing in Canva. Start drawing in Illustrator. Start drawing in on your Apple Pen with an Apple Pen and the iPad. I think you're going to find it's a totally different thing, because what happens is when I draw something in Illustrator, if I don't feel like the line is good enough, what can I do? I can erase it. So easy, right? I can erase it. I can smooth it out. I can add anchor points to it and change the direction, all right? So like an initial drawing for me in Illustrator is pretty bad, you guys. It's not that good, and that's okay. I'm okay with it. I know that I can fix it. And in fact, I have been known, because I've been doing a lot of hand drawing recently for some of my fonts, and I was hand drawing some things, and I was so frustrated because I would actually put my fingers on the paper and try to do a control Z, you guys, like, or command Z, which is on a Mac. You guys, there's so ridiculous on the paper, okay? I truly believe anyone can learn how to design. I really believe that. You can learn how to be a designer, okay? You just need the right resources, the right strategies, the right skill set, okay? But just like most things in this world, it is a learned behavior. It's not because someone is uber talented and they're just like so much more talented than you, okay? Usually, especially when it comes to style, everybody has a different style, so it's all subjective, okay? There are objective things you can learn as a designer. What, like the hierarchy of things, dynamic type, knowing where to place things so that your eye is following things, using negative space. These are all graphic design elements that you can learn how to use, okay? And you can even, while doing it enough, learn how to illustrate. I always believe it's muscle memory. In our Ink Club Creative, I try to do some fun art things with you guys. So we like some, like, I think there's a mini class in there that's like watercolor, just for the fun of it. Because most people are probably like, I'm not going to watercolor. I'm going to do the craft project, or I'm going to do the quilting project, which is totally fine. You get to do whatever you want in Ink Club. We just try to provide the resources to you. But some people will do it and they'll be like, oh, that was like fun. That was like easy peasy. And I'm like, yeah, because it's muscle memory, you guys. It's just getting your hands and your fingers to do the things, making your muscles work for you, and just remembering how to do the things, you guys. So if you are saying to yourself, I can't draw, I'm not an illustrator, I want you to rethink that, okay? Maybe find resources where you can draw. I do a free Illustrator course, not course, Illustrator tutorial every Wednesday that you can go check out on my YouTube channel, okay? So you could go do that. Or you can join Design Bootcamp and I would show you exactly how we do it to make sure that you can draw when you're getting in there, okay? But I really want you to get rid of that belief that you can't draw, because you can. And you can even more so today than ever before. So hopefully this helped you. Hopefully if you have this limiting belief that you will kind of push it to the side and go find some ways to draw on the computer or accept your style and your drawing ability, your doodling, because so many of the greatest artists out there, and they're doing wonderful things, book covers and all sorts of wonderful things, they're just doodling, okay? So find your style and doodle it out, and I look forward to seeing you again. Hey, did you know that you can visit me at makeanddesign.com to learn more about this podcast and join my VIP group for weekly freebies? I can't wait to see you there.